What's up guys, MarvelousDream here, and if you're already on this video, then I'm guessing you have problems with Snap Camera, as they just did discontinue it as of today, 1/26/2023. But not all is lost. We have a great, great human being by Jakku, who provided us a backup server, basically so that we can continue to use filters and all that. As well as I want to give a shout out to Nutty, because he did... provide us info that it was going down, and he's just a great guy. But I'm gonna show you guys how to get the Snap Camera to work for you again. Now guys, so the first thing, like I said, you want to do is have Snap Camera. If you guys already do have it downloaded, and it's the 1.21 version, then you can skip ahead. I'll provide you guys a chapter where you can get to the other step. First step, you're gonna need Snap Camera. Now if you already have it downloaded, do not uninstall it like I did, or you're gonna have to go to a third party to re-download it. So, Nutty did provide us one, snapcameraup2down.com/windows. I'm gonna put the link in the description. For whatever reason, this was not working for me correctly, so I tried a different one called Filehorse and downloaded that, and it worked for me. There's also another one, but I did not try this one, and it's called the Soft Tonic version, basically. But any of them should really work for you guys. You want to make sure you have Snap Camera installed, and then you also want to make sure that you have it completely off and exited so that it doesn't mess with when you transfer some files. I'm going to show you guys how to download it. I'm on that file horse. It's going to go into downloads. It's going to take a little bit. I have slow internet. I don't have Google Fiber. I hate it. Get me out of this place. But once that installs, of course you want to, that's just the install, so you want to install it completely, open the file. Sorry, my screen is over here, so I'm not the best, I'm sorry. But yeah, just guys, go ahead and install that. Once it's done, I'll show you some more things. Now I'm going to show you guys the next step of basically putting a patch on it so that you got the gray screens and the whiteout and all that you guys see when you open up Snap Camera. It's gonna go away. You'll see all the filters that were saved by Jakku. So, all right. And for the next step, once you guys have Snap Camera downloaded, you're gonna want to go to the GitHub that I am gonna provide. Again, it was by Jakku. He gave you guys instructions on how to do it. Basically, he wants you to go to this. So then you're gonna go to your Snap Camera file, which I'll show you guys in a second. Alright, the big step here is to go to where you guys downloaded the new Snap Camera, or where you have it installed, and then you're gonna go into the, head over to Snapchat, click that, and then it's gonna come to this, and then you're gonna find your file, and choose it from the directory where it should be, so I'm gonna find that real quick for you guys, but it's just in local disk, local file, snapping, Snap Camera, there it is. Select the exe, make sure it's not the installer, but the exe itself. You're gonna click open. All right, and then that's the right one. Then patch file, obviously the Snap Camera 1.1. Go ahead and apply the patch. It's gonna download another thing. Now, this is where you might have to have your antivirus off and stuff like that. Or if you have Windows 10 like me, it just says keep, show more, keep anyway. And before we run it though, what you want to do, the best bet is to go to your directory where you have it downloaded, delete it. Once you get that download from the Snap Camera patcher, it's gonna open up, and then it's gonna download that, and then from your downloads, so you don't wanna open the file, but what you're gonna do, like I said, you're gonna delete that original one, so Snap Camera exe, gonna delete that, and then you're gonna drag over that new one from the patcher. So you're gonna drag that over, continue, drags it over. And then you're going to rename it. You're going to get rid of the patched here. Period EXE. Continue. And then you guys can run it. Then it's going to open up. And you'll see that you have filters. It'll go through all this as well. And then that's all set. So there's your filters. Obviously, you want to get your camera. I have my camera on OBS right now. But you choose your camera, all that stuff. All right, and here's you want to have Snap Camera open before you guys have OBS open. What you're going to do in OBS, if you guys already know how to set it up, you're going to go to your video capture device. You can also add one and then video capture device. But I have one, so I go to properties, and you're going to click Snap Camera, and you're going to deactivate it and then activate it again. once this is all set up. So device default, and then now you can see on stream it looks different, and you can see it. Yeah, now you can see it better. If you guys are wondering how to set up like Snap Camera for Twitch, as in having it so that it can have different filters, like rewards and stuff like that, I'm gonna put a video for you guys from Nutty that explains it, and then he can help you guys out with that and getting that all set for you guys. If I did help you guys in any way, please leave a like, maybe check me out on Twitch, and stop by sometime, and just let me know I helped you. But you guys have a great day. If you have any issues, I'm sure we can all help in the comments. And thank you again, Jacku, and thank you again, Nutty. I appreciate you guys, and thank you so much for caring about the streaming world here. You guys have a good one. We'll be right back.